advanced questions.
The first, sorry, the first one was easy. So, I will ask right now. So the question was, I have a website, I don't have a caching plugin. No.
Let's see. We have a website with
caching and without.
With caching, activate cache, and you got 4 seconds.
So the difference is
more
than 1 second, that's what you were saying?
Yeah. No. And if I not activate cache, the site goes with 5 seconds. Yes, let's say just like an example.
So you have caching and with caching you have 4 seconds.
Yes.
And without the caching, you have five.
10, no matter what. How can I make? Without...
It's simple. You already have a caching solution there.
No. The question is, how can I make without activate caching to have 4 seconds?
I can create your own cache.
Cu cache activat, avem 4 secunde.
Da.
Cu cache dezactivat, avem 10 secunde. Cum fac cu cache dezactivat să am 4 secunde?
Păi simplu, răspunsul a fost chiar la final. Optimizarea trebuie să se facă la nivel de server.
Totul e legat de cache acolo.
Încă o dată.
Vreau fără.
De ce vrei?
Poți fără.
HTML.
Se poate fără sau nu?
Poți, ai putea fără,
adică
dar...
Se poate resursele serverului?
Da.
Sau
da.
Care ar fi posibilitățile? Asta întreb.
Da, se poate, dar acel se poate e un maybe. Adică rămâne de văzut. Știi de ce? Pentru că în mare parte contează foarte mult portul de pe acel server. Mulți oameni, de exemplu, nu știu chiar
lungimea
și ăștia de la...
Bandă.
Lungimea de bandă, tot,
țeava, ce...
tot.
Adică trebuie toate mărite?
Mulți spun, îți dau SSD, dacă ne ducem la bromar, nu e pur SSD, adică nu e SSD 100%.
Da.
Dar puțini oameni știu lucrul ăsta. Dacă îi luăm la puricat pe majoritatea, o să descoperim că nu tot ce promit ne și dau. Dar lucrurile astea, ca să fie demonstrate și să fie prezentate, e foarte greu. Plus că majoritatea dintre ei nu recunosc anumite lucruri. De exemplu, un lucru care îl recunosc chiar și în ziua de azi este că serverele de la web, o bună parte din serverele de la web pe hosting, sunt încă încrângași. Și de ce le țin acolo și de ce le am acolo? Pentru că am construit o rețea de internet care tot folosea servere. În cei 15 ani de activitate, am schimbat, că asta povesteam chiar și la networking, am schimbat echipamente de... undeva la vreo 5 ori.
Adică e posibil să am un server cu, nu știu, 300 de euro pe lună și să am un procesor pe el de 10 euro.
Tu poți să ai un server de 300 de euro pe lună și să ai un page load de 10 secunde.
Da.
Asta e răspunsul. We will continue in English, Cătălin.
How about Lightspeed? You didn't say anything about Lightspeed. They have caching on server and also on front side. I know that you are a fan of Varnish and Nginx, but small websites and small WooCommerce websites are running well on Lightspeed as well.
Cătălin.
I've tested it.
Cătălin. I am using Mac right now, but Mac OS is built on top of Linux. Okay? Exactly. I will answer right now. Mac OS is developed on top of BSD. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So from the beginning, I didn't have a computer and I did build a network company, a small ICP for good connections. When I started, I didn't have Microsoft, believe me. But I did have Debian. And with Debian I did start that. In my opinion, in my answer right now, what I'm trying to say is many solutions will come from open source, like WordPress. And the solution of Lightspeed is not open source. I'm wrong?
No, I'm
wrong. No, there are some sysadmins here. Okay, so Lightspeed is a commercial one, but if you're using that, you have to have cloud Linux cloud or cloud Linux. Sorry. So you have two licenses. You are only asking as an agency right now. Should I choose a provider that is giving me Lightspeed? This is the question, or as the end client?
I wanted to ask your opinion regarding Lightspeed versus what you already presented.
It's a very, very good solution. This is the answer you want to hear from me. Yes, in my opinion, it's a very, very good, solid solution. But in every solid solution, there has to be a catch, there has to be something. And in my opinion, the problem is when you have...
The price.
What?
The price.
No, for the end client, it's not the price. Sorry, I did answer as an entrepreneur, sorry, as a hosting company, or an entrepreneur that has a hosting company. So, the answer is like this. If you have only a presentation site or a landing page, definitely you should use that. But if you have something that needs connections and have many queries and you have clients that have others and you use WooCommerce, I would not recommend. Why? Because in most of the times in testing, in real environment, you have a campaign on Facebook, and when people come from that campaign, the page will be the same in the let's say Black Friday campaign. Mm-hmm. Okay, so it's not, in my opinion, it's not usable for a campaign. But if you have a small site or a presentation site, yeah, that's the way to go. But the problem there is with the database.
Why?
Because if I invest in the caching solution or the web server solution, I will not invest in the database. Okay? Mm-hmm. The database needs to be optimized every time. Every time. A sysadmin has to come, has to measure the things that are used in the server, and every 3 months it has to be optimized. So in my opinion, the problem is not with the web server or the caching. In some many cases, the problem is with the database. Okay, so you will fix only one thing. Okay, now questions.
Okay, thank you.
Good question.
Alex, sorry, I was late to your presentation, but I like the idea.
It was an easy WordPress optimization for beginners.
Well, I was going to say, I think it's a great idea getting support for a small business, and because I don't like to spend too much time
in the
computer.
Yeah,
that's
definitely
not my strength. So, how about, I've got a program called Elementor, I think it's Elementor.
Yeah, that's the builder, yeah.
Yeah, so if you get involved in your company, does your company have familiarity with these types of plugins?
Yeah, definitely.
So it's something that you can support as well.
I'm laughing right now because the biggest one, that's the good one, that's the positive one. You are already using a good builder. But if you didn't heard about Visual Composer or Fetch a Bakery, that's good. But what I'm trying to say is that many clients till now use a builder, Visual Composer, And they are horrible, but we have support for that, yeah. Because some teams use custom blocks for these builders, and if you have a custom block, yeah, we will say that's one, it's a custom, but we come with a first level support for even for that block, even if that block is custom. Yeah, we help first thing, we will answer some questions, yeah. But if you use Elementor, in my opinion, it's... I didn't invest so much as an entrepreneur in Elementor. Right now, I will say to you publicly, but I invest with Breezy. And when I say I invest, I'm working with them on an integrated solution. Breezy is practically the same, but it's still in developing stage. Other questions?
Regarding these composers, what are the differences, or what's important regarding the composers from the hosting point of view?
They have to be cached. Because many of the builders will generate lots of files of CSS, and you have to combine them and cache them.
And how much it matters?
Yeah.
How much it matters? Which composer do you use?
It matters a lot. Part of you. For me, as
for me to know about the hosting, if the composers that I use are, I don't know, compatible, or you said that you are now in Breezy.
We are not coming to the client and say, hey, if you use this builder, we will not take that project. But we will give an environment that we know it's usable, not the fastest environment, because it's a problem. Hosting doesn't mean fast, it means it's accessible. This is in my opinion what it has to do.
I think what I am trying to ask is the hosting can recommend a composer that works better.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
I recommend
Elementor. I recommend the Beaver. I recommend Breezy.
Recommend from the...
They are optimized. Yeah, they are fast and they are optimized. Yeah. Better optimized than VC Bakery.
So some composer can work better on some hosting comparing with others.
How to choose one?
I think this is the question that I'm trying to ask. If I have a hosting, if I...
The technology are the same.
There are some composer that will work better.
Guys, what I am using, everybody is using. In my opinion, it doesn't matter. If I choose to use Easy Engine, have you heard about Easy Engine? Or some of you who have environments with Easy Engine? No, nobody has environments with Easy Engine.
What is that shit?
that shit is fast. If I have tomorrow a client, a big client, that's the way to go. It's free, it's fast, and it's there. It's click, 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 install, put it there, and that's it. And you have a good, solid environment. It doesn't have a control panel. It doesn't come with security problems. It's easy.
So do we have one final question before we move the discussion outside?
And we go to pizza and we go to drinks.
Well, eating pizza.
After pizza.
May I?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
As I know, I talk in English. I know. So, yeah.
Okay.
And
in
a database, we have a table where all registration are in it. And in MySQL are 2 million lines. What happens if I have an WooCommerce are 2 million lines in that database? What happened then?
you have a big database.
If you put, if you import, or if you already have, and you have to, you want
I
to
have
migrate.
Orders. I reach to 2 million to maximum. What happened?
This is real or is
science fiction? We don't have 3 million right now. That's the maximum that the stable can have. And the question I think is what happens when I will reach the maximum?
Yes, yes.
Okay. No one knows.
It will crash.
Definitely must crash. Yeah, it's Oracle. It's
MySQL.
We use MariaDB.
I mean, what WordPress? I don't know. I don't stay every day to see.
I'm not a developer anymore. So what I'm
it's about.
Yeah.
SQL.
Okay. What are the chances to hit those?
Yeah.
Those 2 million.
Yeah, a spam bomb can do that.
Because everything is registered in there. It's not.
It's not that hard. In fact, I mean, I think at some point we used to have more than 4 million entries in WPost or WPost meta. In WordPress, or plugins before used to they didn't use custom tables, so they put everything in WPost or WPost meta. So if you had a forum, if you had like digital downloads. Then we had 500,000 users, and we had lots of data added there. So, the solution that we can—it's not necessarily related to hosting. So we are hosted on Pagely, and it was like a really good server, really well optimized. But this didn't help. So the solution that we had was that we either use Elasticsearch to perform the queries in a certain way, or you can cache some queries that are made in a database. I think on the caching part, you can cache database queries, because some queries that we had took more than 2 seconds or something. So if just the query to the database takes 2 or 3 seconds, and then you have to download everything and to do all the stuff, it's not really really work fast. So I think the solution right now for huge databases is to use Elasticsearch, which I don't know to say much more about it. You can read more about it. But this is the solution right now that huge websites are reaching.
Yeah, I didn't come across this situation, but I think I didn't come.
In a big.
But imagine every time you are optimizing the database, right? If you optimize every time,
what means optimize? What the module makes?
What?
The module.
What does the optimizing do? I think you are trying to say
so
that.
You will create some sessions and some
important session. Which one?
You have to clean the WooCommerce ones. Believe me, those are the problem.
Orders?
No, not the orders.
Just clean the database and not reach the
transients and
if you
the sessions.
You reach the 2 million, but if you optimize your database and clean it,
because I have a project with e-commerce big, and I am.
So in
what
that situation,
they reach
okay.
WordPress, what do WordPress?
Okay.
Stop, blank screen, white, I don't know.
Lost the connection with the database. The database will crash. Definitely will crash, yeah?
Will crash, huh?
Yeah. It doesn't matter if it's Maria database or MySQL. But the solution will be to have the database separately. So in a separate server. If you do this, I think...
There's also 2 million. In one table.
You already have this situation?
No, I'm thinking in advance what can happen if. And
good, very, 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 very good question.
This is only.
It's a theory. No, it can be a real.
What can be?
The real situation, I didn't come across.
If I have also module with statistics, if the module makes its own table, it's okay, but if that module not make individual table and put also in same table.
Yeah, Yonuz, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Already, Yonuz has responded to that question with Elasticsearch, but he presumes that you have 2 million, right?
Yeah. The thing is, like, the answer that we got back then from Pagely was like, we can pay a lot more money to upgrade our database. Our database was already a dedicated database.
Okay.
And he said, okay, we are paying something like $400 to $500 per month for it. And he said, okay, we can pay, you know, maybe 2,000, but this will make just a small difference. Won't make like a huge difference. And at some point, you will need to throw in development in order to optimize how your website
so works. So this is the right response. So definitely you have to optimize the database.
Through
development. So what is causing that? Because it's a problem.
Maybe we'll find the answer over a slice of pizza. Thank you again, Alex.
Thank you very much.